about that my grandfather.
Because I see some strange things happen in my life. So I want to query what is happening. And those who saw him were the one telling me about it. I never met him. It was only my father. Mm-hmm. So if you see my name and you see Emmanuel Muhammad, that's my direct father.
Okay.
I want to represent my own father.
Okay.
That is the person I know. From my little knowledge, this is somebody I know. I can talk about him. I can tell you my father's best food. I can tell you his don'ts and do's. If you understand me. So, but that of Onyon Orekaike, I can't present him well.
That's it.
No. I fought it. Every of my statement about him is not clear.
Can I go?
Are you listening to me? Let me be clear with you.
I'm listening.
Did you hear me?
I hear you.
But there are people who had time with him.
Okay.
Who can talk about him.
Okay.
And anytime they are talking, I listen. In fact, I want to enjoy that. I enjoy people who talk about Onyon Orekaike. I never knew him. I never met him. So if you ask me about Onyon Orekaike now, I will tell you what people told me about him.
Okay.
That's it.
Are you getting what I'm saying?
Okay.
So if you want me to tell you clearly, I will tell you. Thank God you also know that your Quran was born 570 AD. I have everything. So I don't argue some things. And not only Quran, we have other religions. We have other. And every one of them has something to say. Why about Christianity?
Thank you, sir.
Everyone of them is just talking about Christ.
Now you are.
Everyone is just talking about Christ. Why Christ?
Pastor Emmanuel.
Why the Bible?
Pastor, so you.
That's the question.
That's the question.
Let
me now stand up. Now, you may
Sir, please.
Let
me come back.
Okay.
I can't offer today.
This is offer.
I'm a Christian.
I'm
proud of it.
So everyone came from Abeokuta. No, I'm working in Lekki. What did you say? Abeokuta? No, my family there.
No, I said it from.
If I'm living here, I'm going to Abeokuta.
You're
welcome, sir. Yes, sir. Welcome.
We're waiting for Pastor Emmanuel. Now, welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Now, Pastor Emmanuel made an analysis and I enjoyed this. He said he didn't know his grandfather. He knew his father. That's true. But he said if anybody tells him about his grandfather, he will believe. Forget it that there are two men in the world, your enemy and your friend. If you meet your grandfather enemy, you tell your brother is a very bad man. That will be your prayer for life. If you meet your friend, your grandfather's friend, will tell you your father is the best friend in the world. That will believe. But forgetting that God is there before Jesus. God was there before Adam. The same God that was with Jesus, with Mary, with Noah, who was with the same Muhammad, was here. God that has revealed what happens, what transpired between Jesus and his people then to Muhammad, cannot make a mistake. She cannot be his enemy, not his friend. He will say the truth. So that's why he has revealed everything I put to Jesus. That's why I say we should go back by this Quran. Mr. Brother Emmanuel, I quoted question number 4. Let me take you back.
Yes.
The Quran said those that give that record are in doubt. With no accurate knowledge of what you are saying. But God said, for surety, they killed him not. That was God that was there.
They killed him not.
Yes.
In the Quran.
Now, I now cited how was Jesus arrested. One point. I said, we are going to fall.
Oh, that was why
you. Hey, now. yes, now. Now, we have 4 points. I told you that I left my house 30 minutes ago, yes. Down here. Nobody can tell me that you can drive from Ijesha to Island for 10 minutes. No, it's not possible. You would ask me, how do you get here? I said, the Christian who asked the question, how did Jesus get to the tree? Nobody asked. He was crucified. How was he crucified? What's the process? The process we are now looking at. How was he arrested?
Inspirational process. We are looking at.
And I said, I'm now second question, but before you pass, I'm not going to jump to the conclusion. We are not talking about faith here. This is knowledge. Believe in anything. Nobody is compelling you to believe me.
Let's talk of religion, let's use our perfectly with anybody.
There are other books that we have read because we are seeking knowledge. That has given us details of activities that will now compare to what we have in the Bible.
Thank you, sir.
They are witnesses that we don't even know their name. In those days of Christ too, they were not disciples. Probably they were atheists. They don't even have a religion or Judaism or something. But they were always present when Christ was operating. They just wanted to see what this man was doing. They don't want to believe it. They are just onlookers. And they have their own reports too. Because then, it was not only Luke or Paul that was knowledgeable. They just happened to be around Christ. That's why they were noticed.
Okay. Was Paul around Christ?
I'm coming. I love that point.
Yes.
Now, who was there when angel came to Mary? Was it Matthew, Luke, John that was around to give the account?
Give the account.
Yes. Was there?
God bless you. That could be talked about.
Who was there?
If my wife visited an angel, an angel visited my wife, I have friends like you are my friends, and we discussed about it in the night. We came in the morning.
Thank you, sir.
That is recorded.
Thank you, sir.
Which means
when the angel appeared unto Mary,
yes,
Mary gave the account to Joseph.
In toto, she ruled him,
sir. Now, Joseph now called the writers to.
You don't have to be saying, write it down.
No, don't laugh. How will you learn when you are too sentimental?
No, it's what you said.
There are people worshiping,
writing. That's what something.
There must be reasons.
For somebody, God is not giving.
What has been going on between us, I have not been writing it down. I might not even have full knowledge of everything that has happened.
That is appropriate knowledge.
Now, I decide to say, while he was alive, I enjoyed everything that went on.
Exactly.
I began to write.
Your friend.
He did not tell me to write.
And now?
But I know that at the time,
Can I quickly ask a question?
I will be here.
Why is Bible based on somebody say?
That is
somebody
this.
Say. God bless somebody
you.
Say.
God bless you.
Wait, Quran has been a total, complete message.
Good.
All over the world. Yes. It has won. If they eliminate the whole of the Quran in the whole of this world today,
yes.
From the head, a single man will come out and he will write the Quran again.
Correctly.
From A to Z. Without no mistakes. Without missing anything.
Hello. Let me tell you. Have you answered?
It is a message. Direct message from God. Why is Bible based on Paul said, the first letter mentioned the word Christian, that is not something I expect you to compare with your knowledge.
These are activities that occur that people decide to write. If you want that, you
buy. Listen, you have been talking since. Let me talk. Sit down. With due respect, sit down.
With due respect.
From heart to heart, did not mention its own name. Bible. There is nowhere in the whole of the Bible that the word Bible is written.
Yes.
And there is no single page in the whole of the Bible that the word Christianity
is written.
The first time they mentioned the word Christian It happened in Antioch.
Antioch,
and you know.
Antioch is not in Jerusalem now.
Is there anywhere where Prophet Muhammad was mentioned, Elijah?
Of course,
yes.
In the
Jesus' name was mentioned
many times, even more than
Professor Muhammad. Let's have you now.
It's because he has came before.
For you to know, we know so much about
him. We're reporting about talking about him.
Of course.
Why? So you
can't. In the Quran, Jesus' name was mentioned in so many places, so many verses.
And in the Bible, somebody who was born 570 after Christ was mentioned.
Yeah.
Who was that?
Yeah, Muhammad.
Muhammad.
Yes.
There is a proof to that that
so you have Muhammad in the
Bible. Even you as a Christian, you are not
a revelation about Muhammad. There are things I am aware of.
I told you God was there during Moses. God was there during Adam. God was there then reveal what happened to Jesus to Muhammad.
Let's take this Muhammad in the Bible.
Now, let us agree on one thing.
Okay. Can we go to
Let's agree. Can we deviate? Want to deviate? This is not our topic. If you agree,
and we come back, we come back to the
news. Just show us. Let's deviate.
We are not jumping to that side.
No, we've agreed. We'll come back. Let's deviate. Now, before the birth of Christ, of Jesus, I will not use Christ, Jesus. Because Christ was not a name, it was a title.
Yes.
There are prophecies. Somebody asked me one day, show me in the Bible, as you're asking me, Muhammad in the Bible. And I said, show me from Genesis to Malachi, Jesus. He said, he's not there. I said, what? He said, because he's yet to come. We only have prophecies. Description about him.
From where?
From the Bible.
From where? Genesis to what?
To Malachi. Jesus was not mentioned.
Show me.
Christ, his name was Christ Jesus. His name, the Godfather gave him the name, the Almighty God gave him was Emmanuel. God is with us.
Yes!
Heavy, please. I want to get 1 point. Is Jesus a title or Christ?
Christ is his title.
Okay,
Jesus. His name was Jesus Emmanuel.
Oh, Emmanuel. Oh. When he was given back to, what
his was name was Emmanuel. What is with us? That's six now.
I said, prophecies don't come with names. Mind my word. Luke chapter 2 verse 21.
At this day,
when he was given Jesus. They named him Jesus.
And when the days were accomplished, for the sacrifice of the child.
I'm coming now.
I thought you were disagreeing with
you. Now, Jesus as a name came in the New Testament when he was alive. I said there was no word Jesus from Genesis to Malachi.
Now, thank you.
Because it's here to come. They call him Emmanuel. Emmanuel means God with us. That's not a name. God with us.
That's
a statement. It's a statement, not a statement.
So you're taking out the statement?
Hello, sir.
No, it's okay. He has a statement. Emmanuel was named Jesus because in that day there have been prophecies that somebody was coming that will be so great, his star will shine so bright that the whole world will bow before him.
Where is it?
Then, where is it? It is there, please show.
Sure.
It's simple. Show, please show.
No, tell him the verse.
Sure. It's go to Isaiah, you will see it there.
The Lord sent a word.
The Lord sent a word
into Jacob, and it hath lighted upon Israel. Verse 9. And all the people shall know.
All the people
shall know. Even Ephraim and the inhabitants of Samaria that say, in the pride and stoutness of heart.
It's all right. They come to verse 6.
Verse 6 now. For unto us a child is born.
For unto child is born. Unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. Of all the people of the world. Are you
Mighty God.
Now, please, Eddie.
You cannot exercise a little question.
No.
See, whenever you're talking, do you see how I give you?
I said, Abilandit.
In 7 verse 14, he said, therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. This name Emmanuel, it was the same thing
mentioned in Matthew 1:23.
Listen now, sir.
This is Emmanuel.
So is it coming to Matthew? Now, so there was this revelation in that guy.
Heavy.
I was talking about you.
I was talking about
Emmanuel was named Jesus. In the books that we have read, books of knowledge that we have read, it's because people acquire knowledge. That's why you see them forming different kinds of He has been announced before time that he was coming. Okay. Everybody was alert. Okay. Then Aaron was king.
Okay.
Then people came out. They saw the star. Okay. Then we call them the witches of the Persian Gulf.
Okay.
The Bible translated them to be three wise men. They were actually the
last man standing.
We call them astrologers because they can read the stars. Right. They have them now in our world. Okay. When they see the stars, they know the meaning of those stars. So as soon as they saw those stars, they knew that revelation as well. Aaron has his henchmen, he has his magician, he had all too. As those three wise men, they just happened to be the first to see. Those ones saw after all. And they went to heaven. That something is going to happen. Because revelation has come upon the family of Christ himself, they decided not to call him Emmanuel. They've been hearing that Emmanuel decided to give him Jesus. So they can conceive him, so they will not kill him. Do you understand? So his name originally has been Emmanuel. But now for concealment, they name him Jesus. So Aaron and his people will not kill him. He will be able to live and do the work that has been said. That is that because of that name, Jesus and Emmanuel.
Thank you very much. Now, we debated to
5 minutes. 2 minutes.
Now, our topic was Jesus in the Bible.
Yes.
Mame, sorry. Okay. I said, no, the word Jesus has not come to existence in the Old Testament. The word Jesus has a name. Now, Pastor quoted Isaiah chapter 9. Verse 8, verse 6 to 7. Isaiah 9,
was not a prophecy. Look at what he said. Unto us a child is
born. Unto us a child is born.
Not will be or shall be.
That is in case.
I'm out of school now. Okay. Can we compare that with Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14? Where is it?
Therefore, the Lord Himself shall give.
He shall give you
a sign.
A sign.
Behold, a virgin.
That's a prophecy. Isaiah 9:6 said, "For unto us a child is born."
That is literally.
I'm coming, sir. Unto us a son is given. Now, this son given. The government shall be upon this small boy that is given. Nobody knew that boy until today.
And his name
shall be called Wonderful, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. So it's not for Jesus. Although I don't have time to elaborate on that.
No, I'll give you extra. Yes, carry on.
Now, tell us. I said nobody knew that boy. Also today, but if it's for Jesus, let's analyze.
Okay.
Now, the prophecy said he shall become wonderful. The government shall be upon his shoulder. Means what? He shall be our leader. That he shall be the ruler. That's the meaning. The government shall be upon his shoulder. Has given us root? No way he has root.
He is ruling us spiritually.
He's coming, sir. I'm coming, sir. We are not our spiritual friends. Physical aspect. Jesus was being questioned, are you their ruler? He said, no, I'm not going to rule the world. John chapter 18 from Master verse 38. My government is not of this world. If I'm to rule, if I'm to be ruler, my servants must afford you not to be arrested by the Jews. That's one point. It's not a ruler. Counselor, sir. Okay, John chapter 18.
It's there.
Now, another point now. Counselor means somebody that can counsel you when you're maybe in mess.
We can give him another
time. There's another
thing.
Okay.
I'm still on that. Then, if I'm going to see further my statement, I want to be clear of the clarity of your Quran's explanation.
Yes.
Are you getting what I'm saying? About who God is and who Jesus is and what happened. Did you understand? I'm talking to you.
You are 3 minutes now.
Yes, in this, I'm true. I just
went okay, back to you. Another deviation.
No, we are still on that. We have not cleared it.
Our new topic is Muhammad in the Bible.
You've not shown me.
I'm going to die.
I'm not showing you. I made a comment.
Okay.
I said to the Jews a stumbling block.
Yes.
To the Gentiles.
According to Paul.
Excuse me. Excuse me. That's your little knowledge.
I'm showing you Paul is.
Excuse me.
Paul is a liar now.
Excuse me. If you want me to go into Paul's credentials, when you even think you get it wrong.
Me.
He must define himself.
Me.
Okay. I know where you want to go.
Let's do that.
Who said he was talking at a woman?
Don't worry.
You know you said something that you don't want us to go. See, everything
now,
about this
is in the Bible.
Excuse me. Everything about this. It's a mystery.
Yes, it is. But where is everything?
Are you listening to me?
And you said that?
Yes. So you want me to show you? It's a mystery. Everything about the kingdom of God is a mystery.
Show me. Jesus said. Show me.
You're reading the Bible, not see the mystery of the kingdom.
Jesus said,
this is a mystery. Even in the book of Matthew, you will see the mysteries of
which time is now? No. Pastor Emmanuel said, the Bible is a mystery. Don't you get it? And I said, show me where Jesus said, my word is a mystery.
And
what he said is from
Paul. He said, very, very, I said unto you.
He says in the. He said everything about this man.
Show me where the
Bible says. He said it is revealed.
Jesus said.
It's not revealed to the wise.
Jesus said.
It's not revealed to the prudent.
Put in Paul. Paul is the example of Jesus.
Can we see something in Matthew chapter 2:11?
If you believe. Let's see. Please.
Let's talk
Jesus in Matthew said.
Chapter 11.
Okay. Verse.
Verse 25.
How do?
At that time, Jesus answered and said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and prudent.
What's he referring to?
You have hidden these things from the wise and the what? Prudent. Those who think they are wise.
And what has, and those who think they are what prudent. Has God
He has hidden this thing from them.
What has God eaten from them?
And has revealed it, have revealed it unto babes.
What?
Even so, Father, for so it seemed good to your sight. I'm singing it again.
What?
Excuse me, I'm talking.
Yes, no, no,
excuse me.
No, I'm not watching the time.
Excuse me.
See now.
When you see,
immediately
after
time.
This, I won't talk again. When you were talking, I always give you time.
That's why I said, let's have time.
I tell you, just when I
call you,
I'm supposed
when
to
do when
talking
when
now.
When I call you, Afa, when I call you talk.
In your minutes.
Hello?
I just call you. Minutes.
Come. You finish your 3 minutes and this man showed you.
And now, when I'm when you started yours,
and when
you directed the words to me.
Yes, and that was clear.
And now,
you couldn't clear it, then I came back to this place again.
You can, don't want to talk now, you want to talk.
Okay, let's say, let's do it like this. Start your 3 minutes now.
Now.
And don't ask questions.
3 minutes now. Let's make it 5 minutes.
That's what I'm saying, but oh, you
have to put that kind of time, sir.
For like, if he asks me, if he asks me questions, I'll use his minutes.
Yes, you answer
I'll use his minutes.
That's when I ask you now.
I'll use his minutes then now.
I'm not going to
when I ask you
7 minutes after.
When I ask you questions in my minutes, you answer me.
And now,
when I ask you in my minutes,
this is it. And now,
when I ask you in my minutes,
can I ask you?
Okay.
Okay, I still take that same scripture. Okay, I'm still there. Matthew chapter 11, verse 23. At that time, Jesus answered and said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and prudent, and have revealed it and revealed them to babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in your sight. All things have been delivered to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, nor does anyone know the Father except the Son, and the one to whom the Son wills to reveal him. He said, come unto me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
Okay.
Clear word. I just have only one word here. He said, this thing has been hidden from certain people. The wise. And he mentioned the people. The wise and the prudent. But they were revealed to children. That means, I want you to now look at human analysis. Look at children and look at those who think they know. That is the way of God, the way God works. The what you think you know, you don't know. But it comes to reveal it to those who you think will not know it. Do you get what I'm saying? So it's not going to be about your reading of your books. It's going to be centered on nothing but his knowledge, his revelation. And these are the people he chose to reveal these things to. There will not be any other Bible that will be written. There will not be any other Bible that will be written. We've gotten series of translation, number one from the Greek, Hebrew.
from Hebrew to Greek, and from Greek, that's it talking about, trying to relate it in our simple understanding and knowledge. And you get what I'm saying? And it is best given to us for us to just simply take it the way it came, and not to bring in what we think we know into it. That is why if you read the book of Revelation, it says, do not add and don't remove. Did you hear me? I think it's my 3 minutes still waiting.
5 minutes.
I said 3 minutes.
No, no. Everybody conclude on 5 minutes.
Did you get what I'm saying? Okay. And to
renew 1 minute.
To maintain it all, I still stand on the point that those who were not there were not there. And if you want to let me know that somebody is there, prove it. That is why I write my case.
Now, me, I'm not deviate again. Muhammad in the Bible. I said earlier that there is no place in the Old Testament, Genesis to Malachi, where the word Jesus was mentioned as a name.
We have heard that.
It's, I'm coming already.
5 minutes.
I need to remind us. Now, Muhammad in the Bible, the word M-U-H-A-M-A-E-D cannot be seen because the Bible has been completed before his arrival. This is my vision.
And it's a prophet that is coming from God.
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Why did God talk
about it?
I said, Pastor Solomon did not even understand me. I said, prophecies don't mention names. That is why the word Jesus was not mentioned in the Old Testament. They use this Emmanuel and all sorts of appellations for Jesus. Not the word Jesus. It was after his birth. At the eighth day, Luke 2:21, they name him Jesus. Not even Jesus Christ. The word Christ came to existence through the Greeks, the Gentiles. He knew anything about, he never had Christ when he was alive. Now, Muhammad in the Bible, there are prophecies and descriptions about Muhammad in the Bible. One, Deuteronomy chapter 18. Deuteronomy chapter 18. We have two prophecies there. One for Jesus, one for Muhammad. Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 15 to 17 is for Jesus. 18 to 20 is for Muhammad.
Deuteronomy what?
Chapter 18.
Verse what?
Verse 15 to 17 is for Jesus.
Can I read it?
From 18. From 18.
Can I read it?
Read.
Which one are you reading? From 18.
From 18.
You said from.
From 18. Let him read the two. Let him read Jesus' own and read Muhammad.
Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 15 to 17 is for Jesus.
Okay.
Deuteronomy chapter 18.
The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from your midst, from your brethren. Him you shall hear. According to all you desire of the Lord your God in Horeb, in the day of the assembly, saying, let me not hear again the voice of the Lord my God, nor let me see this great fire anymore, lest I die. And the Lord said to me, what they have spoken is good. That's 15 to 17. 18. I will raise up for them a prophet like you from among their brethren, and will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all. He shall speak to them all that I command him. Should I still go on?
Continue to 20.
And it shall be that whoever will not hear my words, which he speaks in my name, I will require it from him.
Now, that's
but the prophet who presumes to speak a word in
it's
my
okay.
name,
it's okay.
which I have not commanded him to speak.
It's okay, now it's my
you
minutes.
Have to finish it.
It's my minute
no.
now.
Okay, okay.
It's my minute.
I was wanted to read up.
No, don't worry, don't read up. Don't read up. I have 2 minutes left. Now, I say 15, if you said that thing very well. 15 said, I shall only read.
The Lord
the Lord your God will raise up unto you.
Will raise up. He was addressing the Israelites, the Jews. Moses you. Now.
He a said, prophet,
a from prophet the of you. From your midst, among the Israelites. Continue.
Of your brethren, like unto me.
Like unto me, Moses. It will be like me.
Unto him,
unto
you shall hearken.
You shall hearken. Hear his voice. Verse 18 now.
So I will raise them up.
I will raise them. That's another thing. We are going to get 15 and 18 now.
I will raise.
Go to 15.
15. The Lord your God will raise up unto you.
Unto you.
A prophet.
The Israelites. Unto you.
A prophet.
18 now.
So I will raise them up a prophet.
I will raise them.
A prophet.
A prophet.
From among their brethren.
From among their brethren. We have two.
Like unto you.
We have two nations. Israel and Ishmael. Israel and Ishmael. Ishmaelites are the Arabs to Muhammad. The Isaac from Esau and Jacob. Jacob had 12 children. Those are the Israelites. Now, we have two parties now. Israelites and Ishmaelites. God now said to the Israelites, I will raise them unto them, the Israelites now.
From among their brethren.
Among their brethren.
When God was talking there,
let another person
somebody has something to say, go.
Yeah, let me tell you.
5 minutes now. 5 minutes.
Yeah, we keep trying to you. Everything. There's a way at which God communicates. You're getting me. When you are under the influence of the Holy Spirit, and God is using you to prophesy to people, you're getting what I'm trying to say. He can start using you talking on most occasions. I, you're getting it. That's the first one. Let's say, I will raise. Onto you get what I'm trying to say. The second one, the word used there was
them.
The second one, the first one was I.
I will raise them up a prophet.
Yes, okay, that's one. The next one, go.
The first one.
That's the first one. The second one.
The one I read now.
15.
So the 15 said, the Lord your God will raise up unto you.
You can hear now. You can hear now. He is talking. I.
With the Spirit of God. That's God.
The Spirit of God talking. You're getting me? Came now, interpreting what he's saying. You're getting what I'm trying to say? In a verbatim knowledge of man. The Lord your God will raise unto you. You're getting what I'm saying? Them. I think he used them, they all.
Unto you. The first one, unto you.
See, is this talking to the same person?
That is what I'm trying to say. It's the same person.
Simple English.
But the context
that you read this
is
Alhaji. Can you please read this?
The context.
I read it. Please help me understand this. What's not talking to two people?
Yeah, two people.
Huh? You read this? You read this?
No, we can't be so far.
Oh my God! There's no way. Let's go. Please, can you read this? Look at verse 17. Elijah, I want you to concentrate. Elijah, concentrate. Concentrate.
No.
See, he said, the Lord your God will raise up for you. And the Lord said unto me. See, is he talking? Oh my God. Is somebody here? Okay. He said, see.
What's the time now?
So this is what?
What's the time now?
Oh my God, they should have
asked
for this discussion.
Please,
Have you can see the
please, oh God. Maybe when we get back to our homes.
You, I want you to study this place. That's your place.
When you go back,
you
back home. Hello,
let me
keep it. Can you read this? Can you read this?
Let me go.
Can you read this? Oh my God.
Let's
get a million proofs.
Now,
sorry, there is
But before you go, before you go,
have a
please,
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 please, please,
Is it Saturday?
Is it
Fact about Christianity and Muslims has to do
who have I not given?
About faith between the Christians and the Muslims. In order to know that religion should not be the cause of disorder.
Yes. Yes.
He gave me one book.
Okay, what are you driving at?
God is going to personalize something. Who was the person that brought all this thing to you?
Yes.
Oh my God, I love this.
We just need some understanding.
You see, you must be
educated.
You are fast. He said, no, don't task me after righteousness to be
balanced.
After righteousness.
So, the Saturday by 11. Let's
what did he say? What is that?
No, he will bring you. He will bring you.
No, let's.
Tunji.
I said Aladji should write those points. Let us have it by WhatsApp.
Please. And now, I'll send it to you.
You will send it to me. So that when we come, we just go to
those points.
We will not even spend more than an hour.
Aladji, you see where we're at now?
did it again.
Don't worry.
The first one.
It's part of the project.
Show me the law of salvation.
It's part of the project. They are doing the best for the sign coming up for the money. It's more than just a job.
It's not that. Afa, you come up. It's part of the
project. It's more than just a job. 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 It's more
than just a job. It's more than just
That's my point. Jesus was never made Christian. It was according to the Quran. Quran 4 verse 1, yes. Verse 157. Allah said to Muhammad, Quran here and now, this is funny. For one of you, lying.
They've been preaching in English.
Lying.
Okay. But he said, you ghost.
Okay. For.
Said in boast.
The Quran said, the Jews said in boast.
We killed Jesus Christ.
We have killed Jesus Christ.
The son of Mary.
The son of Mary.
The messenger of Allah.
The messenger of God.
But they killed him not.
But they killed him not.
Nor crucified him.
Nor was he crucified.
But so it was made to appear to them.
They felt that he was killed, crucified.
And those who differ therein are full of doubt.
Those that are even proclaiming the message are full of doubt.
With no certain knowledge.
With no certain knowledge.
But only conjecture.
Conjecture to follow.
To follow. Mm-hmm. For surely.
For surety.
They killed him.
They killed him not.
That is the book of
Quran. Quran is Quran.
Verse 157.
That is your knowledge of Quran concerning the death, I mean the life of Christ.
No, the death.
The death of Christ. Yeah. Is there a place that is written like that in the Bible?
What you are going to do now is this. There are some points that are
those that are dead, we understand.
No, what I'm saying, those that put down the records.
Yes.
They are like in Matthew, doubt.
Like Mark, Luke and John, they are in doubt.
Jerry, okay. They are full of doubt.
There's no accurate knowledge.
Yeah. With no certain knowledge,
okay.
But only conjecture to follow. For surely they kill you.
That is the proof of
God. Yeah.
Now, I want that same proof to be read to us in the Bible.
Thank you.
Where we can now see that Matthew, Mark, Luke and John were living in doubt. They were living in uncertainty after that report or before the beginning of this report.
Now, let's read this way. The first thing, how was Jesus arrested? The Quran says,
I'm coming, sir.
The Quran said, those that put down.
Now, I'll first of all read there. Now, come back to what Quran said.
Okay.
Yes, Jesus Christ was arrested.
For what?
23. Let me. Okay, 23 verse. From verse 20.
Okay.
He was arrested, brought before Pilate. Pilate, therefore, willing to release Jesus, spake again to them, but they cried, saying,
crucify him. Crucify him.
Big screen.
And he said unto them the third time, why? What evil hath he done? I have found no cause of death in him. I will therefore chastise him and let him go. And they that were instant with loud voices, requiring that he might be crucified. And the voice of them and of the chief priest prevailed. And Pilate gave sentence that it should be as they required. He gave sentence that he should go and crucify him. You are getting what I'm going to say?
Okay.
According to the book of Luke. And he went ahead with his sentence and he was crucified. Now,
before you go out from that,
now let me come to a place. Okay? Let me come to a place. There's something that we need to know in this place. There's something we need to know. What is the origin of heaven?
Okay.
And what is the origin of plural?
Okay.
You want me to?
Yeah.
I have a Quran in my house.
Okay, that's good.
Written by the Bible Society of Nigeria.
Okay.
To witness to the Muslims in the north.
Okay.
I never knew I was going to be here today. You're getting me. I just called upon. I was born in the north. See the northern Muslims killing your brothers.
They are not killing.
Excuse me, brother.
No, my God, please.
I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
Please.
Killing my brothers. Never recognize them as Muslims. I've seen my brothers killed, my Yoruba brothers, in the north. Mosque being raised down, slaughtering them like animals, saying they are infidels. They are not Muslims. Are you getting what I'm trying to say? I'm from Ogbomosho. My family, the Christians and Muslims. We took ourselves as one. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
During Sunday, we go there, we celebrate with them. During Christmas, they come to us to celebrate with them. And we have never raised hands against each other before. That's what I'm trying to say. Now, going deep into some certain things, you get what I'm trying to say? We find out that even our so-called brothers that are Muslims, you're getting me, are not recognized as Muslims. You heard me now. That's why I say let us go to the origin.
Now, before I'm
coming, of scriptures of the truth.
I'm coming, sir.
I'm coming, sir.
You know,
you said something.
You read Quran, that,
sir, you read Quran that they say was not crucified. I read Bible now.
No, I'm coming. Before, wait, a minute, sir. Exactly. I'm coming, sir.
Are you getting
what I'm saying? A minute, sir. Going by the, by your experience, you know. You see, this is the constitution of the Muslims. Quran. Bible doesn't have the Christians. If any Muslim does anything outside this, he's not a Muslim. So if a Muslim can kill a Muslim, is he a Muslim? It's not possible. Because Quran 49 verse 12 says Muslims are families. Come what your denomination, anything. So a Muslim can never raise down a mosque. They are not Muslims. Okay, you know the term now, Boko Haram are Muslims. Of course they are not. That's propaganda. They knew that. So don't let us go into that. Let's face what we are here for. All those ones are not, they are all propagandas.
Now, the origin
of the Bible.
Of the Bible. You're getting me.
Okay.
The origin of Quran.
Okay.
Quran said a certain thing. You are getting that he was not crucified.
Okay.
You are with me?
Yeah.
The Bible said he was crucified.
and he rose up with a big bag of money. And he was able to get a pen. And the Bible says, plus
And we have every proof, witnesses of the demonstration of his crucifixion and his resurrection. Are you guys what I'm trying to say? And the proof of it is the manifestation of his name. Him bearing himself witness based on the truth that was written in him. Are you guys what I'm trying to say? The Quran says you will not be crucified. You them that believe the Quran will not go there. Are you getting me now? If the Christian says, the Bible says he was crucified, to them that believe the Bible, they stick to it.
To them that believe that he has given
the Bible, I'm coming, sir. Now, to now prove
the origin,
I'm coming, sir, that he was crucified.
No,
I'm coming, sir. I'm coming. And he resurrected the third day.
Let me take it back. He said, the origin of the Bible and the Quran.
Okay.
That's where you are heading to. Before you
go I started the origin to say that you have said I should forget about the issue of.
That's not the origin of Quran.
No, see, there's no hour to talk about the origin without talking about that. You said I should forget about it.
No, answers are not ours.
If you talk about it, one, let him laugh.
Let's do this here. Timing.
One question at a time.
Timing.
No, let's not do it times. One question at a time.
Okay.
If you say a question, let him answer to that before you go into another.
The thing is actually going to look complicated. Let me give myself space to talk.
Yes.
I am a Christian and I represent my faith here.
Exactly.
Spongy, which can't be moved. We had met before, maybe I should let you understand. And they know my points. I was outstanding. Say to them, they know where I stand. I was not moved, and I had proofs backing my doctrine. Now, this point now is as he tabulated before now, that they said Christ was not crucified. That was what the Bible said, that was the Quran said.
Yeah,
that is the argument. Apparently. The argument is what I do not really understand. By the Moje Mashe Kotei, it was Uganda. I do with you. This is the way I want to think. It is some other people's doings. Don't go there. If we choose to believe that Christ was beneath, Christ was crucified without investigation, I think we are comfortable with it. We will investigate when you have facts and proof.
Exactly.
If my Bible says if my doctrine says Islam is not good, my Bible is not comfortable enough or convincing enough to tell me. It must be able to show me in the Quran why that doctrine must be abolished. Do you get it? You just told me now that Christ was not crucified. That's what you said. In the Quran, I want a verse or two in the Bible that supports that. That is my stand. You are not able to bring that up. Listen to
that. That's where we are going. That is where we are going.
So you now listen.
That's where we are going. So he has obtained a point. Exactly. Of course. That's the point there.
In fact, it's a good
now. From my sorry, sir.
Your name? Your name? My name is Jamie. My name?
Solomon.
Solomon.
Sir?
Pastor Emmanuel. Now, our point, sir, our point now is this. Distractions. I have what?
If we had left whatever we have to. And we'll come here, please. Yeah. Suspend every other discussion. Please. And let's get to get one or two things. Sir, what's your name, sir?
Alhaji Yusuf.
Alhaji Yusuf said something, and I love that. He said that he wants to be convinced with this religion. To start with, Christianity is not a religion. Christianity is a life. Did you get me, sir? Christianity is a life. It's not a religion. You get what I'm saying? Good. And